day and age to read any good news on the newspaper page. And love and tradition of the grand design, some people say, is even harder to find. Well, then there must be some magic clue inside these gentle walls, 'cause all I see is a tower of dreams, real love bursting out every scene. Smother the blues with tenderness. Days go by. There's room for you, room for me, for gentle hearts and opportunity. Days go by. It's the bigger love of the family.
Welcome back to Soul TV. So today I'm going to be reviewing The Diary of the Wimpy Kid book. This is the very first one. It's by Jeff Kenney, and I think this is probably the best book you can read this summer. And they just came out with the new book, Wrecking Ball. It's right here, and you can buy it in stores, Lakeshore, Barnes & Noble, just any book place, even Amazon. And I will be showing you a demonstration on how you would act while reading this book.
3 weeks later.
Hey, hi. Do you want to read this book?
Yeah. Diary of a Wimpy Kid is such a great book. I really enjoyed it.
Good. So this is how you would act when you would read this book. I hope you guys enjoyed Real Reader Review. Bye!
My name is Sophia, and welcome back to the last episode of Soul TV Sports. For this school year, 2020, can you believe this school year is coming to an end? Well, for this week's last sports segment, this week's question is, are the 805 Youth Football Leagues coming back to play this fall? Well, according to the local sources, the Ventura Buccaneers will not be playing this season due to the current situation with the COVID-19. It's confirmed they will not have season this fall. On another note, the Austin Knights, the Warriors, the Panthers, the Ventura Packers, and the Cameroon Cougars are to be determined. All right, sports fans, that's all we have for this last sports segment. Hope you all have a safe and healthy summer. See you all next year.
That was such a good movie. Oh, hey, Francis. Today I'm going to be reviewing the movie that just came out yesterday. The movie's called Artemis Fowl. The movie is about a boy named Artemis Fowl who's trying to figure out how to bring his dad back. His dad disappeared. Well, his dad was taken by somebody named Opal, which I don't know who that is because whoever it is just under a hoodie. And then soon Artemis meets a girl named Officer Short. and she helps him try to bring back his dad. Soon, movies in summer, like Soul, the Disney Pixar movie, is going to come out maybe this year. And the other movie, the SpongeBob movie, might come out this year also. I definitely recommend checking out Artemis Fowl because it's on Disney Plus, and if any of you have Disney Plus, you're in luck. Catch you next time!
Hello, Jordan.
Thank you for sending me, Doctor. I have an appointment right now.
Okay. Go ahead and sit on the couch. Jordan, why are you here today?
I'm here today because I'm really depressed. And Soul TV's ending and the school year's ending and I'm just really depressed.
Then why don't you just record your last segment?
Whoa, I never thought of it like that. Thank you, Doctor. I'm having a breakthrough.
Here's your book. Let me do your last edit on your medical.
Thank you, Doctor.
Well, bye-bye. On June 15th, 1836, Arkansas became the 25th U.S. state. On June 16th, 1884, the first American roller coaster opens in Brooklyn, New York. On June 17th, 1885, the Statue of Liberty arrived in New York. On June 18th, 1882, U.S. President James Madison signed the Declaration of War against Great Britain. These are some pretty good edits, Doctor. On June 19th, 1846, the first official baseball game was played in New York and was in 1846. On June 20th, 1975, the summer blockbuster movie Jaws was released about a great white shark attacking swimmers. On June 21st, 2003, J.K. Rowling's fifth Harry Potter book, Harry Potter Order of the Phoenix, was released and became the fastest selling book ever. Thank you, Doctor. I feel much better.
How are you doing?
Better. I can't believe you solved my problem. I thought no one could. But you are the genius. You earn every single penny that you earn. Here's a tip. Never cross the road without looking at both sides.
Okay. Bye-bye.
And that was your week in history. Thank you and good night.
Hello everyone, welcome back to What's Cooking with Lexi. Today we're going to be making box brownies. I figured we should end off this season of Soul TV with a dessert to celebrate, so let's get started. All right, you guys, in a medium glass bowl, I have a half a cup of vegetable oil, 3 tablespoons of water, and 2 eggs. I know that was so hard. Oh my gosh. Okay, so let me show you. I am doing the wet ingredients first, so this is what it looks like, and I'm gonna mix this in my handheld mixer on like a low speed. All right, So I'm gonna do it on maybe like one or two. Nothing too high. All right, you guys. So I already went ahead and poured in half of the brownie mix into the bowl. Looks pretty well combined. So I'm gonna pour in the other half. But also, you might need a spatula to scrape down the edges because we want all of that brownie batter to go into like the bowl, like not on the sides, because you want to use as much as you can so that way you fill up your like brownie batter. Okay, the powder smells like hot chocolate, but now that it's incorporated, it smells like brownies, which is a good sign. If yours doesn't smell like brownies, I don't know what you put in it. All right. So I'm just gonna mix the rest of this and I'll get back to you guys when I'm gonna pour the batter in the pan. Also, you wanna preheat your oven to 350 degrees. This is what I'm putting my brownies in. I already greased it. Oh my gosh, I was just trying to say. I already greased it with butter Okay, so I poured all the brown batter into my pan. Let me show you what it looks like. All right, guys, so this is what the brownie batter looks like in the pan. And to get those air bubbles, I'm going to slam it on the countertop, but I can't do it with one hand. So let me prop you guys back up and do it. All right, so you just want to go. It'll bring most of the bubbles to the surface and then pop them. All the air bubbles are out. I'm going to put it in the oven for 24 to 26 minutes. So I'll get back to you guys when they are baked. All right, you guys, so here is the finished product. Look at the brownie. So I ended up putting it in the oven longer. It was about like maybe 48 minutes, but I didn't put it in for like 48. I like did like 5 minutes, 2 minutes. And that was because I noticed that at 26 minutes, it was not ready. And that's okay, so don't get scared if it does not, like, it's not cooked. Because I guess it was a 9x9 pan, I thought it was a 13x9. So, I'm pretty sure it's an 8x8, yeah. Alright, so it's okay if it does not come out in 26 minutes. It's normal. Typically brownies cook longer, like 30 or more. So yeah. Alright, so that's what it looks like. Okay. Alright, this is these. I'm gonna start. It's just really good. It's rich. I think I got milk chocolate brownies, so it's a richer flavor. I really like them. They're nice and chewy, and the top gives it like a nice texture. I like my brownies chewy, so I have nothing to complain about. Yeah. I recommend you make box brownies, and cheers to one season done of Soul TV. All right, so thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed watching me bake box brownies. I hope you try it out. I will see you next season. Hopefully What's Cooking carries on to season 2. Yeah. Thank you guys for like support.
Show off your natural hue, flamingo. Oh, 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 oh. If you're multicolored, that's cool too.
Friday challenge of the school year. So here it is. We want to kick it off summer a little bit with this challenge. Get us ready in the summer mode. So we're going to do a flamingo stance challenge. So with this challenge, you're going to pick one leg, whatever leg you can balance on the longest. You're going to bring the other leg up. You're going to hold that position. And we're going to see who can go the longest. You cannot switch feet, so you can't hop and change in the middle. You have to hold one foot on the ground, same ones, stay down whole time until you can't go any longer or you fall. We'll see who can go the longest, have a little fun with it, get in the summer mode, relax, enjoy the sun, and have a good summer.
Flamingo.
Hello, Rio del Sol, Mr. Romano here. This past season for Sol TV, we've shot 14 episodes. Now, not every take was perfect. And now, it's time to take a look at some of those not-so-perfect takes and a little behind-the-scenes look at what it was like filming Sol TV. So, enjoy and roll that footage.
You see what I mean? He's so mean. I mean, I'm so sure. But
I'm walking on sunshine.
I thought something else. I thought you said this with that. Hello, sports fans. Unfortunately, there's no sports.
And I don't want to spend my whole life just waiting for you. Now, I don't want you back for the weekend, not back for a day. And no.
You didn't say your lottery. It's not green. Birthday.
I'm walking on sunshine.
Ladies and gents, this is the moment you've waited for. You've been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor. And buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what can gather. Your fever dream, can't you see, getting closer. Just surrender, cause you feel the feeling take
over. Throwing your heart through every brick wall. I kickstart the rhythm, all the drama's in remission. No, I don't need permission. Feel so good to dance again. Feel so good to dance again. With my emotions, I'm just not going in with everything to dance again. Feel so
I'm blue.
Singing, we will.